Welcome to my presentation. I am Onur Alkan. My department is Electrical Electronic Engineering. I am a student at Antalya Bilim University. Let's go to the topic. My presentation topic is my project. So, water level indicator with alarm. Firstly, I want to talk about Internet of Things. The Internet of Things, shortly IoT, is a communication network where physical objects are linked with each other or with larger systems. It is embedded with sensors, software and other technologies to connect and exchange data with other devices and systems over the internet. Now, I would like to mention about how it is working and some advantages. An IoT system needs for different components to function properly. Sensors or device, connectivity, data processing and the user interface. An Internet of Things system consists of sensors and devices that speak to the cloud through some form of connection. First, sensors or devices collect data from their environment. This data is then sent to the cloud. Various methods such as cellular, satellite, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth can be used to send data to the cloud. When the data reaches the cloud, the software takes some kind of action on the data and processes the data. The system can then decide to take an action. What is important at this point is that the software system without the need for a user can do this process by sending a warning or automatically adjusting the sensors or device. This device can do most of their work without the for human intervention. However, this doesn't mean that it is closer to human intervention. Users can interact with this device to adjust access data or give instruction as they wish. As for the some advantages, information. It is obvious that having more information helps make better decision. Whether it is mundane decision, as needing to know what to buy at the grocery store or if your company has enough widgets and supplies, knowledge is power and more knowledge is better. Monitor. The second most obvious advantage of IoT is monitoring. Knowing the exact quantity of supplies or the air quality in your home can further provide more information that could not have previously been collected easily. Furthermore, monitoring the expiration of product can and will improve safety. Time. The amount of time saved because of IoT could be quite large, and in today's modern life, we all could use more time. Money. The biggest advantage of IoT is saving money. If the price of the taking and monetary equipment is less than the amount of money saved, then the IoT will be very widely adopted. Let's go on the project now. I will summarize my project. In this project, I made a water level indicator with alarm using Arduino Uno, Arduino IDE, water level sensor module, buzzer, jumper cables, breadboard, resistors and relays. Thanks to my code in the Arduino IDE, I set this project to show three water levels via LEDs and give an alarm when the water level is full. If there is no water, the LEDs will not light. If we add some water, the weather sensor detects the weather and the green LED turns on until the weather level is halfway. When the weather level is increased and reaches the half level, the green LED turns off and the yellow LED turns on. When the weather level reaches and reaches the full level, the yellow LED turns off and the red LED turns on, and an alarm sound is coming that the weather has reached the full level from buzzer. Also, these values were used as the weather level sensor reads up to a maximum of 400 millimeters. We are now in the introduction part. Weather is a very important research for humans, especially for people in arid regions. The amount of weather is decreasing today due to global warming. So people should know the value of weather and use it carefully. The weather level indicator with alarm helps people on this subject. For example, people can understand how much weather is left, how much weather they use, how much weather they have by looking at the color of the LEDs in the weather level indicator with alarm. So also, they can understand that the weather levels are at the full level with the LED color and alarm sound. Weather level indicator with alarm can be used in factories, dams, weather storage areas, experimental place, hydroelectric power plants, school and many other places. For example, we can check weather pump action, detect weather leaks, detect precipitation. Also, we can use it in experiments, for example, precipitation rate calculation. In addition, thanks to this project, companies and people will save money, They will not waste weather in vain. They will be able to control the weather and be precautionary against weather leaks and rain. This project will contribute to the development of the world as a scientific and daily life. I will talk about the components that I used in the project. These are Arduino Uno, water level sensor module, jumper cables, buzzer, three LEDs, breadboards, and resistors. Firstly, I will explain what is the Arduino Uno. It is an open source microcontroller board based on the Microchip ATmega328P microcontroller and developed by Arduino CC. The board is equipped with sets of digital and analog input output pins that might be interfaced to various expansion boards and other circuits. The board has 14 digital I/O pins, 6 analog I/O pins, and it is programmable with the Arduino IDE via Type B USB cable. It can be powered by the USB cable or by an external 9 volt battery. Through it, a capped voltage between 7 and 20 volts. Secondly, I will explain what is the water level sensor module. This sensor can be used to measure the water level, monitor a sump pit, detect rainfall, or detect leakage. The sensor produces an output voltage according to the resistance, which by measuring we can determine the water level. The water level sensor has only three pins. Signal pin is an analog output that will be connected to one of the analog inputs on your Arduino. Plus VCC pin supplies power for the sensor. It is recommended to power the sensor with between 3.3 and 5 volt. Also, the analog output will vary depending on what voltage is provided for the sensor. Minus GND is a ground connection. Thirdly, I will explain what is the jumper cables. When building Arduino circuits, we usually use jumper cables. It can be comfortably attached to and removed from breadboard and Arduino. I used female-male wires when connecting the weather sensor module to the Arduino. I used male-male wires in my Arduino and breadboard connection except for the weather sensor module. Thirdly, I will explain what is the buzzer. A buzzer or beeper is an audio signal device which may be mechanical, electromechanical or piezoelectric. I use the buzzer as an alarm. Fifthly, I will explain what is the LED. The LED stands for light emitting diode. It is converts the electrical energy to light. I use green, yellow, red LEDs. Sixthly, I will explain what is the breadboard. Breadboard is the tool on which we test our circuits. It allows us to easily test the circuit we built without soldering them to each other. Seventhly, I will explain the resistor. It is the most important circuit elements in electronic circuit that serves as current limiting, voltage division, protecting sensitive circuit elements against overcurrents. The resistance value is measured in ohms. We know the Ohm's law formula. Now let's go to the code part. I have different which LED connected to which digital pin of the Arduino. Green 6, yellow 7, red 8. I also definite the buzzer to 13 because I connected it to Arduino's digital pin 13. I declared green, yellow, red and buzzer as output. Later, I initialized it serial begin communication at 9600 bytes. Later, I read the analog value from the input pin and transferred it to variable length level. Later, I sent the level to the serial monitor. Later, I made the green LED turns on when the level is between 1 and 200. Later, I paused the program for a second.
Later I made the yellow red stars on when the level is between 201 and 350. Later I paused the program for a second. Later when the level is between 351 and 400, I made the red light turns on and I made the alarm sounded from the buzzer. Later I paused the program for a second. Now I will describe the project circuit step by step. Firstly, I placed the LEDs and resistor in the breadboards. I connected the cathode of each LED to power rail on breadboard, which would be the ground supply. I connected the anode of each LED to different nodes. I connected 220 ohms resistor in series with each LED. Because if I connected the LEDs directly to the power supply, too much current will flow through the LEDs and the LEDs will probably break. To prevent this, green LED indicates low water level, yellow LED indicates half water level, red LED indicates full water level. We can see it in the first photo. Secondly, I connected the LEDs with digital pins on the Arduino. I connected the green LED to digital pin 6 on the Arduino. I connected the yellow LED to digital pin 7 on the Arduino. I connected the red LED to digital pin 8 on the Arduino. We can see it in the second photo. Thirdly, I connected the water levels modulate to the Arduino. I connected the minus pin of the water level sensor to GND on the Arduino. I connected the positive pin of the water level sensor to 5 volt on the Arduino. I connected the signal pin of the water level sensor to A0 on the Arduino. We can see it first photo. Fourthly, I connected the buzzer. I connected the positive leg of the buzzer to digital pin 13 on the Arduino. I connected the negative leg of the buzzer to ground on the breadboard. We can see it second photo. Fifthly, I used 5 volt and GND for our main power source. I connected the plus on the breadboard to 5 volt on the Arduino. I connected the minus on the breadboard to the GND on the Arduino. Now, in the project images part, I will explain the station in the project. When we look at the picture, we see the station LEDs don't light because there is no water. When we look at the picture, we see the station when the water sensor detects the water and the green LED turns on until the water level is halfway. When we look at the picture, we see this station when the water level is increased and reaches the half level. The green LED turns off and yellow LED turns on. When we look at the picture, we see this station when the water level rises and reaches the full level. The yellow LED turns on and the red LED turns on. And an alarm sound is coming that the water has reached the full level from the buzzer. As a result, thanks to this project, people will now understand their water level thanks to LEDs. They will also know by hearing the alarm sound that the water level have reached the full level and will use their water accordingly. In this way, people will be able to make water and money mysticism on the days of water scarcity. This IoT project will also help people in their daily business and experimental life. Choose. It will be project that we do not want to remove from our life. These are references. Thanks for listening to me. Have a nice day.
Hi everyone. Now I will describe my project. Firstly, let me tell you the project components. LEDs, green, yellow and red LEDs, resistors, jumper cables, these are female male, these are male male cables, weather level sensor module, buzzer and Arduino Uno. Now I will tell you how I did it. Firstly, I placed the LEDs and resistor in the breadboard. I connected the cathode of each LED to power rail on breadboard, which would be the ground supply. These are. I connected the anode each LED to different nodes. These are. I connected 220 ohms resistor in series with each LED. Later, I connected the LEDs with digital pins on the Arduino. When connected, I used the male-male jumper cables. These are male-male cables. I connected the green LED to digital pin 6 on the Arduino. I connected the yellow LED to digital pin 7 on the Arduino. Yellow cables, you can see. Yellow. And I connected the red LED to digital pin 8 on the Arduino. Red cables. You can see. After I connected the water sensor modulate to the Arduino. When connected, I used male female jumper cables. I connected the minus pin of the water level sensor to GND on the Arduino. Bit minus. GND. I connected the plus pin of the water level sensor to 5 volt on the Arduino. Red cables. To 5 volt. I connected the signal pin of the water level sensor to A0 on the Arduino. S pin. Orange cable. Go to A0. Later I connect the buzzer. I connect the positive leg of the buzzer to digital pin 13 on the Arduino. Orange cable go to 13. I connected the negative leg of the buzzer to ground on the breadboard. Lastly, I used 5 volt and GND for our main power source. I connected the plus on the breadboard to 5 volt on the Arduino. Plus. Blue cable. Blue cable, 5 volt. I connected the minus on the breadboard to GND on the Arduino. Purple.
GND. Now, let's run our project. I uploaded the code. Let's stop light because there is no weather. If we add some weather, the weather sensor detects the weather and the green light turns on until calm the weather level is halfway. When the weather level is increased and reaches the half level, the green light turns off and the yellow light turns on. When the weather level reaches and reaches the full level, the yellow light turns off and the red light turns on and an alarm sound is coming that the weather has reached the full level from the buzzer.
Thank you for watching and listening it.